Welcome to CCBC. We are a Christ-loving and Bible-believing community of people purposely placed by the Almighty in the heart of the nation with the nations at heart. We want to help you become the person God made you to be. So no matter where you are in your journey, you are invited to discover your purpose and live it out at CCBC. Here at CCBC, giving to the Lord is an act of worship. It is a way of thanking God for all that He has provided in our lives. It is also supporting the work that God is doing in the community and around the world. Giving online is the easiest and best way to give. You can give anytime, anywhere, online through BDO, BPI, Metrobank, GCash, PayPal, or PayMaya, or visit ccbc.ph/giving for more details. You can also give in person at our designated offering boxes located at the main entrance of CCBC at 111 West Avenue, Quezon City. We are also one with God and our missionaries in serving the nations. To give by faith through the mission's faith promise, please inform us by sending an email to giving@ccbc.ph. Know that God is honored when we sow into His kingdom. Welcome to CCBC. We are a Christ-loving and Bible-believing community of people purposely placed by the Almighty in the heart of the nation with the nations at heart. We want to help you become the person God made you to be. So no matter where you are in your journey, you are invited to discover your purpose and live it out at CCBC. Here at CCBC, giving to the Lord is an act of worship. It is a way of thanking God for all that He has provided in our lives. It is also supporting the work that God is doing in the community and around the world. Giving online is the easiest and best way to give. You can give anytime, anywhere, online through BDO, BPI, Metrobank, GCash, PayPal, or PayMaya. Or visit ccbc.ph/giving for more details. You can also give in person at our designated offering boxes located at the main entrance of CCBC at 111 West Avenue, Quezon City. We are also one with God and our missionaries in serving the nations. To give by faith through the mission's faith promise, please inform us by sending an email to giving@ccbc.ph. Know that God is honored when we sow into His kingdom.
Good morning, I'm Beng, and Welcome to CCBC's online service. We are glad that you are joining us today for an hour of thanksgiving and worship. If this is your first time, please stay connected so we can all together experience the transforming power of God's presence. Let us enter His courts of praise with these words in our heart. In Philippians 4:8 says, "Whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things." Together, brothers and sisters, let us worship our holy and living God.
Of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some of your sonnet, sung by flaming tongues of love. Praise the mount I'm fixed upon it, Mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise mine Ebenezer, hither by thy help and come. And I hope by thy good pleasure, safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from to rescue me from danger, interposed his precious blood. Oh, to grace how great a debtor, daily I'm constrained to be. Let thy goodness like a fetter bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to
our God is the Holy God, perfect God, and He is also the God of grace and love, who draws near to us when we come to Him. As a family, let us ask for His cleansing and humbly bow down as we lay our prayers at the feet of Jesus. In You, O Lord, our hearts are secure, and we have no fear. In Christ, we have this hope as an anchor for our souls that is firm and secure. As we come in Your presence today, create in us a pure heart and renew a steadfast spirit within us. In love and mercy, You have redeemed us. You have lifted and carried us through daily in our battle against sin. For You desire mercy, not sacrifice. Blessed are those who walk in the light of Your presence and abide in the center of Your will. To keep our hearts guarded from daily temptations and worldly lures, send out Your light and Your truth. Let them lead us to Your holy place and Your dwelling, that we may pursue peace even when circumstances are unfair and unpleasant. We draw close to You, O Father, for we desire Your nearness. Cleanse us from our sins and purify our hearts before Your holy presence. For You delight in truth in the inward being, as You teach us wisdom in the secret of our hearts. May our worship be pleasing to Your sight now and always. Through Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, be all glory and praise. Amen.
Reading is found in Matthew chapter 5, and I'll be reading from verses 8 to 20. This is the word of God. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled by men. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it in its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. I tell you the truth, until heaven and earth disappear, not the smallest letter, not the least stroke of the pen, will by any means disappear from the law until everything is accomplished. Anyone who breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever practices and teaches these commands will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you that unless your righteousness surpasses that of the Pharisees and the teachers of the law, you will certainly not enter the kingdom of heaven. This is the word of the Lord, and He is going to bless our hearts with it.
Peace into each other.
caring. Share hope and joy and gladness of this world that we are part of. And though we may not do great things, we can do small things. We can do small things with great love. Great love. Put Christ into each other's hands. He is love's deepest measure. If love make peace, give peace a chance.
Mayroon isang alamat or folk story kung sabihin na umibig daw ang isang binata sa isang diwata. Hiniling ng babae na kunin ang puso ng kanyang ina at dalhin ito sa kanya habang tumitibok pa ito. At yun nga ang ginawa ng binata. Kinuha niya ang puso ng nanay niya at tumakbo patungo sa babae at sa kanyang pagtakbo ay sa kanyang pagmamadali, natisod siya at lubha siyang nasaktan. At nagulat siya nang usap ang puso na tumitibok sa kanyang kamay. Anak, tumindig ka. Dalian mo. Dalhin mo ako sa kanya habang tumitibok pa ako. Alam kong kaya mo ito. Tandaan mo lagi, mahal na mahal kita. Doon natauhan ng binata sa maling ginawa niya. Today we are going to talk about the heart that is pure and that is filled with peace. Father, speak to us in a special way. As we look into our hearts, Lord, that we may live with inner lives that is filled with purity in the heart, and that we could truly be peacemakers for other people. And this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Our text for today is based on this portion of the Beatitude, Matthew chapter 5, verses 8 to 9, and it goes this way. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Jesus wanted his disciples to live with purity in their hearts and to be peacemakers. Pure in heart, what does it mean? Well, I'm showing you a paragraph that is lifted out from one of my references. It's a word katharos in the Greek. It means without any mixture. It is separated, hence it is clean. And because it is unmixed without undesirable elements. And figuratively, it speaks about being spiritually clean because it is purged or purified from God. It is free from the contaminating or the soiling influence of sin. Let me give you this popular illustration of how it is to be pure in heart. Do you see this water bottle in my hand? Ito ay purified water. Filtered siya ayon dito sa brand niya. It is free from impurities. Therefore, naiinom ito. It is potable. There will be no worry in me that I will be infected by anything, that I will be poisoned. Pure water. It is acceptable. Now let me get something for you. This is also water, but it is water that is taken from the sewer. Galing po sa toilet. Ano kaya kapag ka itong tubig na ito, sewer water na ito, ay inilagay ko dito sa hindi pa nauubos na bottled water na ito? Let us do it. Just a little bit. Ilan patak. And what if I offer this bottled water to you? Takpan ko pa nga eh. But you know very well na nahaluan ko ito. It is contaminated. Will you drink it? Definitely, you will reject it. Ako rin eh. Hindi ko rin iinumin ito. Bakit? Contaminated na siya. Alam po ninyo, ganyan yung standing natin before God. You know, God created us. God placed us in His creation. But because of sin and its influence in our life, we were contaminated. We are not pure anymore. And this is the reason why we are rejected. We are not accepted. As the Bible says, for all have sinned and fallen short and fall short of the glory of God. Talagang kahit maliit na sin na yan, it has contaminated us. And the Bible also teaches that the wages of sin is death. In other words, we are separated from God. We cannot have fellowship with the Holy One because we are sinful and He is holy. That is why, on the contrary, ang sabi ng Panginoong Jesus, blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Mapalad ang dalisay ang kanilang puso, ang kanilang loob, dahil makikita nila ang Diyos. Sa madaling salita, dun sa mga hindi kontaminado ang kanilang saloobin, sila po ang maaring makapiling ng Diyos. God desires that we will have fellowship with Him. However, He desires also that our fellowship with Him will not contaminate His holiness. This is an impossible thing to do. How can we really ensure that we are pure by ourselves when we know for sure that we have sinned and we are contaminated by the evil influences? Our lives is polluted by the evil influences of this world. But the good news is, God is an expert of the impossible. Yes, it is impossible to stand before God on our own. Yes, it is impossible to come to the presence of the glory of God by our own merit, by our own good deeds, by our own religiosity, and by our own religion, and whatever religion that we have joined with. It is impossible. As I've mentioned, God is an expert of things that are impossible. God made purity of the heart possible because of the work of Christ on the cross. Posible na maging dalisay po ang puso natin, ang buhay natin sa harapan ng Diyos dahil sa ginawa ni Kristo para sa atin. Yun yung dahilan kaya siya nagkatawan tao at namatay sa krus ng Kalbaryo bilang sakripisyo para sa kapatawaran ng ating pagkakasala. When Jesus was hanging on the cross, one of His last words goes this way, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do. And to one criminal, He said to him, you know, from now on, you are going to be with me in paradise. An impure, a sinful, a criminal who deserves capital punishment, and yet received assurance of fellowship with the holy, Why? It is because of the work of Christ. The Apostle Paul, in his words, in his letter to Titus, goes this way. Christ saved us not because of the righteous things we had done, but because of his mercy. He washed away our sins, giving us a new birth and a new life through the Holy Spirit. He generously poured out his Spirit upon us through Jesus Christ, our Savior. And it is expected now of us, those who belong to Jesus Christ, disciples of Jesus Christ, that we keep our hearts and our ways pure. Purity, as the virtue, is the capacity of controlling one's body in holiness and honor. In other words, now Christ has cleansed us, it is expected of us to keep our ways pure, not contaminated by the world. Now, how do we keep ourselves pure in a setting, in a world like this? First, we have to be sure about our spiritual standing. Be sure that you stand as forgiven. You have, by faith, received the gift of Christ's forgiveness. And you keep on trusting, keep on putting your faith and living by faith on that reality. You live as forgiven. You live under the grace of Christ. And then second, there's a conscious total surrender. And part of that conscious total surrender is also a conscious total abstinence from these things of the world. Paul reminds us that in 1 Corinthians chapter 16 or 6 verse 19, and it goes this way, don't you realize that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who lives in you and was given to you by God? You do not belong to yourself. He is saying this in contrast to giving ourselves into immoral relationships and fornication. Posible po, amamuhay na may kabanalan, amamuhay na may kadalisayan sa harapan ng Panginoon. Posible po mangyari yon dahil po sa kapangyarihan ng banal na Espiritu sa atin. Kaya naman po, kailangan ng araw-araw na pagsuko ng sarili sa Kanya. At pangatlong bagay po, paano po mapapanatili ang kadalisayan? How do we keep ourselves pure? It is by the constant renewing of our mind. Before our speech, our behavior, our habits become polluted and contaminated with immorality and other sinful things, it is our minds that get first to be contaminated. Kaya napakahalaga para ingatan ang puso mo, kailangan ingatan mo ang isip mo. Ang mga bagay na inilalagay dyan sa isipan na yan, siya po ang magiging magkokontamina doon po sa nilalaman ng iyong puso. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verses 5 and 6, the Apostle Paul wrote this. He says, "We destroy arguments and every lofty opinion raised against the knowledge of God and take every thought captive to obey Christ, being ready to punish every disobedience when your disobedience is complete." Alam po ninyo, the primary place ng spiritual battle ay hindi po nariyan sa labas, na andun po sa inyong isip. Kaya sabi ni Paul, bawat kaisipan, every thought na dumarating sa inyo, isuko nyo kagad sa Panginoong Jesus. Evaluate it in the light of the cross before you receive it into your life. Surrender it to the Lord Jesus Christ. Yun po yung susi. Simple lang yun. May nakita ka? Masyadong naantig ang puso mo? Bago mo ang kinin sa buhay yan, isuko mo muna sa Panginoon sa pananalangin. That is living victoriously not only every day, but even every hour and even every minute in your life. That's why it is important for us disciples to keep on walking with Jesus. See how the psalmist described a blessed man. The first psalm goes this way: Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. So the first part here was a conscious abstinence of things that may pollute, that may influence his mind and his heart. He is saying no to a lot of these things, but he is saying yes to the things of God. You know, he meditates, his delight is in the law of the Lord, and he meditates on it day and night. That's the secret of being blessed. That's also a secret of happiness for a follower of Jesus Christ. So the blessed person gives effort to keep his inner life from being polluted by sin and by worldly ways. Alam po ninyo, sa panahon natin ngayon, pollution is a great global concern. Ang walang habas na pagdudumi ng hangin dahil sa usok o yung tinatawag na carbon emissions, yun daw yung nagdudulot ng tinatawag na global warming na siya ang naging sanhi ng climate change. Ano ba yung pinag-uusapan mo, Pastor? Yung bang tumitindi yung mga bagyo na dumarating sa atin, ala Yolanda, nung dumating ang Yolanda, na iba po yung mga signal number ng bagyo dito sa Pilipinas. At hindi lamang yun, kapag dumating ang tagtuyot, sobrang tuyo, sobrang init. At doon naman sa mga malalamig na lugar, pag dumating ang taglamig, sobrang lamig naman na hindi na kaya ng mga naninirahan doon. Bakit ko kinikwento ito? Alam po ninyo, simple lang, bakit nangyayari ito? Dahil sa pagdudumi ng hangin. Dahil sa carbon emissions natin. Ngayon, COVID pandemic, malaking global issue natin ngayon ay yung infection. Kaya nga, pandemic eh. Nangyayari ang infection kung saan-saan. Dapat, anong turo sa atin? Dapat lagi tayong malinis, nagfe-face mask, nagso-social distancing. Bakit natin kailangan gawin yon? Para maiwasan ang pagkalat ng infection sa ibang tao. Kailangan iniingatan natin ang ating sarili na hindi tayo mahawaan para hindi ka lamang magkakasakit, kundi hindi mo rin hahawaan ang iyong mga kasama sa buhay, lalo-lalo na yung mga vulnerable sa buhay ninyo. We keep ourselves from getting infected so that we could not infect others, especially the vulnerable ones. That's the point of having purity in the heart. It is keeping your heart pure. Why? Because if pollution in our environment is a serious concern, how much more with spiritual pollution within us? If COVID infection is a big concern in our society today, how much more with spiritual contagion or spiritual infection? Ganon din po ang mangyayari sa atin. It will create a lot of damage, but unwittingly filling our minds and hearts with things of the world like bitterness, fear, unforgiving spirit, greed, covetousness, addiction, lust. We fall into myriad problems and cause other people problems too. According to Jesus, these filthy things that is in our hearts, that has infected our hearts, will cause problems not only to yourself but to other people as well. Matthew 12:34 goes this way: For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. If our hearts are filled with hatred, lust, covetousness, these becomes pollutants to other people's spirit. Napopollute mo ang mga ibang tao, naapektuhan mo ang ibang tao. Ang sabi nga ni Jesus sa Matthew 18, What comes out of the mouth proceeds from the heart, and it defiles a person, for out of the heart comes evil thoughts, murder, adultery, sexual immorality, theft, false witness, slander. This is what defiles a person, and therefore it will also affect others. So the condition of our hearts will contribute to the spiritual pollution and the spiritual pandemic of our community environment. That is why about right after speaking and teaching about being pure in heart, Jesus said, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God." Mahalaga ang pagiging dalisay, ang loob para sa gawain ng peacemaker. Purity in heart is needed for being a peacemaker. That is what Jesus is teaching us. If we have impure hearts, we cannot be peacemakers, but we will be peace wreckers. Yan ang tawag ko doon. Ano ba ang peacemakers at pagtuturo ng Panginoon? Peacemakers are, using the words of the New Living Translation, they are people who work for peace. And there are three aspects of this work. Let me share with you these three aspects from the practical word studies in the New Testament. First, they strive to make peace with God. Ito yung mga taong try to discover how it is to experience peace with the Lord. And these people will find it in Christ Jesus. Romans chapter 5, verse 1, it says there, "We have peace with God because of what Jesus Christ our Lord has done for us. He conquers the inner struggle, settles the inner tension, handles the inner pressure. He takes the struggle within his heart between good and evil and strives for the good and conquers the bad." And second thing about peacemakers, they help others discover and experience peace as well. So he seeks and leads others to make peace with God. They help others find security when they are vulnerable. So may mission po itong mga peacemaker. And another thing that is obvious among peacemakers is that they strive at every opportunity to make peace between others. They are agents of reconciliation. As they reconcile people with God, they help them get to be reconciled with their neighbors, especially those whom they are in conflict. Nice kong ipakilala sa inyo ang isang kaibigan ko at isang kapwa pastor at colleague po sa ministry, si Reverend Nasali Silava. Siya po ang senior pastor ng Light of the World Church. Kung kayo po ay nagawi ng Cagayan de Oro, makikita po ninyo ang church nila doon sa Cagayan de Oro City. As missionaries, they are deeply engaged in peace-building ministry among the tribes and armed conflict in Mindanao. Let me share with you his testimonial video and my brief interview with him.
Pastor Nas Silava of Conservative Baptist Association, Northern Mindanao. In 2015, after attending a global leadership summit in Cagayan de Oro, our group thought of adopting San Rafael Talakag Bukidnon as an area that we will have a project on developing a culture of peace. Our group of pastors banded together and prayed for this area. For several years, our group there disbanded because of the skirmishes, fightings, banditry, and many other terrorism activities. And so we prayed hard about this area. And one day, one of our pastors was elected as barangay chairman in the local government. And so when Pastor Puy at Sagayan, I was the leader of that barangay, we collaborated together and conducted several values Bible studies in the different cities. So that area that was noted as a red coded area, meaning lots of conflict, became an area where many people were surprised to note that there was so much a difference that happened in that area. From red coated area, it became a green coated area when the people began to be involved and cooperated in bringing peace in Talakan Bukidnon. And so, one day, the Barangay Captain was able to convince 200 rebels to come down and submit themselves to the government. And so, livelihood came, and help came to them, and Sangapael Talakan Bukidnon progressed very much. So many lives were changed, so churches were planted, and the livelihood was offered to these rebels and people in that area. And so, let's keep praying for Mindanao to be an area of the land of promise, where there's culture of peace, and whether we can continue to see this grander vision spread all over the country. Thank you so much for praying for us.
What does it take to be a peacemaker?
I thought of three qualities that needs to really be developed in progress. The first one is very important to me, integrity, that you are really what they see, outside, inside, or inside, outside. So, ikalawa, yung they know that you care. No? You accept their culture and understand their culture. Then, ikatatlo na quality na gusto nila talaga dito, yung meron kang vision sa kanila na as a leader, they see you as a dato, or they see you as someone that has a positive expectation.
Maraming salamat, Pastor Nas. And in behalf of CCBCers, we bless you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Pastor Nas.
One of the aspirations of CCBC is to be a safe place for healing and restoration. Ano ang ibig sabihin nito? First, we strive to be peacemakers. Tayo po, calling po ng Lord yan. We strive to have peace with God. We encourage others to find peace within themselves and with God. And we encourage conflicting relationships, people who are going against each other, to be at peace with one another. That's part of our mission. And how do we do it? We strive towards purity in heart and in our ways. Narinig natin kay Pastor Nas, it is difficult to do peacemaking kung wala kang integrity in your heart. If there is no purity in your heart, it would be difficult for warring people to trust in you to help them to find that peace. And that the people that we serve and disciple, let us pray and let us strive that the people that we serve and disciple will find safety in our presence. Yes, we want them to experience peace, but sana they experience peace within our presence and they experience safety within us. Nabasa ko po sangayon sa Philippine National Demographic and Health Survey, sangayon sa research nila noong 2017, that 1 in 4 Filipino women aged 15 to 49 has experienced physical, emotional, and sexual abuse by their partner or by their husband. Another thing, 1 in 3 victims of incestuous sexual violence are committed by a close family member. Ano po yung sinasabi nito? Much of this sexual violence happens in the home. 1 out of every 3 victims of sexual violence happens in the family. You know, the family is supposed to be a safe place. The family is a place where people could find peace. At ayon din po sa isang study na ginawa noong 2015, 12% of all rape cases happen in the home. So what do these studies present to us? Well, the home is not a safe place for women and children anymore. We need to engage in peace building. It needs to start not merely out there among the warring tribes in Mindanao, among the ideological conflict that's happening in our mountains. No, it needs to start where we are. It needs to start in our hearts. You know, the scandal that was uncovered after the death of Ravi Zacharias caused many, many to ponder the question, do such spiritual abuse happen in my own Christian community dito sa aking church? And the better question is this, how do we ensure that our Christian community is safe? You know, we are a church. How do we ensure that our homes are safe for the vulnerable people around us? In our small groups, we engage in a lot of disciple making. We grow disciples supposedly in a safe environment. We say at CCBC, ministry happens wherever CCBCers are. This is our aspiration. We also dream, as CCBC has expressed in our vision canvas, that we would like to see CCBC as a safe place for restoration and healing for people who need to be restored and needed to be healed. But it takes all of us to create that safe place. And it starts with our hearts being pure in the spirit and committed to be a peacemaker. So after this worship service, I want you to gather with your family or with your life group and discuss these questions. What advice can you give to others so they can experience purity in heart? Then another question that you may want to ponder among yourselves is this. Discuss practical ways in promoting peace among yourselves and making your safe, your place, a safe place. God bless you. May you experience and enjoy the peace that God gives all of us.
How beautiful.
How beautiful is the body of Christ, not because of who we are, but because of what we have become as a result of Christ's work in us. We are a church, virtually, online, as we are not meeting with each other physically. However, we are also a church with our household. At home, you are a church. And we are a church primarily because the Spirit of Christ indwells in us, especially when we were born again. We celebrate that reality as we break bread together. The bread and the cup commemorates the work of Christ on the cross. As we receive these, we renew our faith in Him. The wine reminds us of the Spirit of God that binds us as one, even if we are separated from each other. All of these are expressions of the Father's love to the world and to all of us. We look forward to the day when we will gather together, not merely at 111 West Avenue in our old chapel, but more importantly and more gloriously on that day when we are going to sit at the feet of Jesus when He comes again. So, let us partake the Holy Communion in a worthy manner. Let us examine our hearts, our minds, in a brief time of stillness and prayer.
Our Heavenly Father, out of your great love, you relented from condemning us. Rather, you gave your Son Jesus to bear all your wrath toward our sinfulness. To this we are humbly grateful. We celebrate what you have done with much thanksgiving and with deep appreciation in our hearts. We offer our bodies anew as a sacrifice of thanksgiving back to Jesus, who gave His all to us, that we may be found purified before the Holy God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Now I want us to hold the bread. In the night He was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took bread, and He gave thanks to God for it. Then He broke it and He said, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us eat the bread together. In the same way, He took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant between God and His people, an agreement confirmed with my blood. Do this in remembrance of me as often as you drink it." Let us drink from the cup. And then Jesus said, "Every time you eat this bread and drink this cup, you are announcing the Lord's death until He comes again."
Forth in fields of conquest, thy tents shall Lord, for such a challenging message, that indeed in such a time as this, meron po tayong mga iba't ibang mga paghamon sa buhay, lumalabas po ang tunay na karakter natin at ang tunay na pananampalataya natin. At ang gusto ng Panginoon ay atin pong ma-develop sa atin ang karakter ng Panginoon. Hindi lang po dun sa gusto niyang bigay sa atin ang gusto natin, kundi yung karakter na maging katulad tayo ng Panginoon. So may it be that yan ating pong panalangin. Let's come before the Lord in prayer. Tunay nga, Lord, na kami nagpapasalamat sa iyong example para po sa amin. Na talagang kayo po ay meek and loving and caring. At kayo po, Panginoon, ay nagpakumbaba. At pinakita mo, Panginoon, what it means to be a true person that comes from the Lord. At dahil kami po, Panginoon, ay iyong mga anak, nais din po namin na makita sa aming mga sarili ang aming pong katangian na nanggagaling at nagpapareho gaya sa iyo. And Lord, ang dalangin po namin is that during this time, let your Holy Spirit work in our lives so that these attitudes will truly become real sign of buhay. At ngayon pa noon, we continue to come before your presence as we ask for your special blessings sa aming po. Salamat, Panginoon, na sa aming pong bansa ay nagsisimula na po ang vaccination program. At salamat, Panginoon, sa mga supplies nito. At dalahin po namin that this will be done in an orderly manner at marami po sa atin will be able to get this vaccine and to protect us, Lord, from this infection. Although alam po namin, Panginoon, na ultimately you are the God who cares and we will seek refuge in your presence at kayo, Panginoon, ang siya magbibigay sa amin ng tunay na protection sa anumang mga bagay. But we just pray, continue, Lord, na ito yung makatulong sa aming pong bansa. We pray, Lord, sa iba't ibang mga healthcare facilities namin, ang mga hospitals, ang mga clinic, ang mga rehab centers, ang mga quarantine centers. Lord, we pray that this will be a facility, Lord, na kung saan marami sa mga nagkakasakit ay mabigyan ng lunas. At the same time, Lord, marami sa kanila, hindi naman po COVID ang kanilang sitwasyon. Marami po sa aming kapatiran ay aming pong pinapanalangin dahil sa iba't ibang mga karamdaman. So Lord, we pray that you bless them and guide them, Lord, so that they will seek and find peace and comfort in your presence. Ganyan din po, Panginoon, thank you because of your promise that you are our great Jehovah Jireh, the one who provides for us. Marami po mga nawalan ng trabaho, marami nag-i-struggle sa mga businesses, marami po ang mga nagproblema against sa schooling nila, ang mga teachers na tuturo, iba po mga sitwasyon ang hinaharap po namin. At lalo na po dun sa mga nawalan ng mga mas buhay. Lord, we pray that in all these things, you would show yourself as our Jehovah Shalom, the God of well-being, na talagang all in all, Panginoon, anuman ang situation, kasama ka namin. And so Lord, even as we continue to seek your face, salamat, Panginoon, sa iyong mga provisions batis sa amin, maging sa ministry dito sa capital city. And so now, Lord, we will receive that benediction. But let me, Lord, na ito'y maging totoo sa amin, that we will seek your face and that your countenance, Lord, will become real sa amin. At makita po namin kung paano liliwanag ang ayong pong buhay if we anchor ourselves upon you. So, mga kapatid, please receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you his peace, now and always. Amen and amen. Oh,
Thank you.